Thank you. Thank you very much. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The Vice Chancellor, Dr. Tariq Rafi, Pro Vice Chancellor. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and students. Whenever I come to this hospital and this college, it's always a nostalgic feeling for me. My first 6 years of life was spent in this hospital, and I lived here because my parents worked in this hospital. That was till 59. After that, I did my house job here. I did my postgraduate training here in the early 80s. And then I was either admitted here under care of a lot of doctors, and I'm personally indebted to Dr. Afridi for taking care of me during that time. So I have very good memories of this institution. I wish I was sitting on the other side rather than standing here and speaking to you, because I am one of you. And how the journey of Sindh Medical University has been a very turbulent one, and Dr. Tariq Rafi knows about it, is a witness to it, that how it took and how many years it took to attain this position. I would like to tell you, don't mention that you are to be self-sufficient by 2021, because then the government will stop your funding. So, as you know, that the financial situation of the country as a whole is bad, there will be cuts. And I think it's a question of sustainability. The other universities will not be able to sustain themselves. That is my honest opinion, because they don't have other sources of funding, and they depend totally on the government. So all universities in the world have to develop methods to become self-sustainable, to be self-sustaining, and you must thank God that you are self-sustainable. Doctors as a whole have been criticized, but their job to the ailing humanity has always existed and will exist. The initial doctors were called as magic men, but then changed over a period of time where modern medicine started coming in. The doctors are known from 7,000 years BC, where some kind of treatment always existed. The turning point in modern medicine came with Louis Pasteur and Alexander Fleming, when he introduced the first antibiotic, penicillin, into medicine, where things started changing. The past is gone. These doctors, these alumni, these friends, I appreciate their services, and they have excelled in whatever they have done in their lives. Their contribution to the society of this city and this country is tremendous, and I hope we have such more doctors who are recognized nationally and internationally, come up and do things in this country. I agree with you that due to our economic condition, we cannot follow the gold standards of medical practice as it is being practiced elsewhere in the world. But we have to learn, and at times doctors coming from abroad tell me that they have to reskill themselves in the economic conditions of Pakistan and the economic conditions of the people. There are cardiac people sitting here, and there are angioplasties being done today in this city, where they put in stents directly without using a balloon. And they in peripheral angiography, they don't even upsize. They go directly with a larger bore, so the chances of risks are there. The city of 200 million or 20 million has only three internationally accredited labs in Karachi. There are only three labs you get. So we need to improve ourselves, we need to improve our services. As far as Sindh Higher Education Commission is concerned, we are still in a quandary. The effects of the 18th Amendment are still there. The Sindh Higher Education Commission is still trying to find its way and drive its path. The funding is still with the federal government and the provincial government, and there is no funding directly of the Sindh Higher Education Commission. So, but we are trying to set up, I think first we should try and set up academic standards, and we should do things which will benefit education as a whole in this province. My goal right now is to set up academic people, have academic people in the Sindh Higher Education Commission, and so that we can move forward. I would not like to take too long, and in the end I would again like to thank the VC for inviting me today and for the great pleasure being amongst you. Thank you.